are talking to Erik de Leon, one of the closest people to Tony Harrison. Break down the fight tonight. A lot of people think it's controversial. I'm getting text messages and phone calls from all over the place about this fight. Harrison, Charlo, what happened?
Man, that was a great fight. You know, overall, there was a lot of close rounds. But I felt like Tony boxed very well. You know, it was a great fight, you know. Charlo was throwing a lot of bombs, trying to catch him with one hand. You know, they were hurting each other. They hurt each other in some of the rounds. But overall, man, I gotta take my hat off to my boy Tony. He boxed very well. And, you know, I want to congratulate him. And I'm happy as hell that he won. You know, he's bringing that belt back to Detroit.
I met you and Tony Harrison the same time. Emmanuel Stewart introduced me to both of you guys. Tell me about both of you working with Emmanuel back in the amateurs, back in the day.
Oh, man, he was a great man, you know. He was a great guy, great motivation. You know, we learned a lot from him. You know, he brought us up, and he had us on, you know, we were in his wing side. He had us on his side all the time, you know. He took us everywhere with him. And overall, we learned a lot from him, you know. And we came up from the struggle here in Detroit, and we're just trying to put on for our family. So I'm so happy for Tony.
Now, I got to ask you about this. Tony Harrison, he had one loss. And we live in a society, unfortunately, in boxing, which is crazy. Because in life, we all lose. Nobody's ever undefeated in life. He had one loss, Erik, and everybody wrote Tony Harrison off. Everybody abandoned the bandwagon. Do you remember that day when he lost? And now I'm proud of him that he's a world champion.
Yeah, no, me too. He works hard, man. He worked hard his whole life. And not just that. He works hard here for the community here in Detroit. He helps out a lot of people. You know, in his gym, he helps a lot of kids, keep them away, you know, try to keep them off the street. So I'm just, if you knew Tony, you'd be super happy because he's a great guy, man.
My only thing is tonight, it disappoints me when there's controversy. When someone wins and they're like, well, he really didn't win. It's a shame because it's good when someone wins and it's a clear-cut win. But nonetheless, what happens now to Tony Harrison? Who does he fight? What's the name of the guy? Who's 154? Jared Hurd, does he fight? Who does he fight at 54 now?
Man, I don't know. I mean, sky's the limit for him. I mean, this is only going to make him better. He's going to give him, any fight that he gets into, it's going to be a great fight, you know, because he leaves everything in the ring. And, I mean, shit, he's a champ now. He's a WBC champ.
All right. What do you tell Tony Harrison if he's watching?
No, man, you know, just like I said earlier and like I always said before, you know, I'm happy for you, you know, and you deserve it. You know, you work hard for it, so I'm up next.
Before they announced the scorecards, what went through your mind, and did you know that they'll score it the way they did?
I was actually, I was at dinner, and then I was watching it. I was with my girl watching it, so I was all excited, but I was nervous, you know, because anything could have happened. It could have went either way, but, you know, like I said, he boxed very well, so I'm happy he got the W.
Okay, I'm going to ask you about a couple upcoming fights really quick. Start with this one. Gervonta Davis, Abner Morris. You know both of them. I think you sparred Morris.
Yeah, no, Morris is strong. People, I mean, I'm telling you, man, he's got a lot of experience. That experience is going to play a big factor, not just because he's my boy and because I'm close, I know him well. I really think that Mars is going to do really good in that fight, you know. So I'm rooting for my boy Mars all the way.
Okay, Adrian Broner, Manny Pacquiao. And you have played the part of Manny Pacquiao in numerous camps. You're a southpaw, you're slick.
Man, I'm telling everybody, I want AB to win, and I think he's going to do it.
Why do you say that?
He's hungry. He's just hungry, and, you know, he has to do it. I mean, like he said, he's got to do it. I mean, he's at a place where his back's against the wall, and that's when he's got to perform. He's got to do it right now. Now this is the time. You know, I like Manny Pacquiao. He's a great fighter. I think he's past his prime. He's still in great shape, but, I mean, Adrian Broner's strong. He can do it. You know, he's athletic. He's young, so I give him that. He's young, and he's fast. He's strong, and he's hungry. I mean, he's got to do it. He's got everything to do it. He's got all the tools. He can box really well, too.
Okay, and then you have, of course, Josito Lopez, Keith Thurman, January 26th, a week after Broner Pacquiao.
Man, Josito Lopez been in the gym right after his fights. He's been in the gym since I go to camps. He's always staying in the gym.
Yep.
Keith Thurman hasn't been in the gym, so I'm telling you, man, he's going to shock the world. He's going to win. He's going to take that belt.
Okay, last one, Mikey Garcia, Errol Spence. You sparred Mikey. I've seen you.
Oh, Mikey Garcia is the truth. I'm telling you. Mikey Garcia can punch. People are going to be surprised when they see him win.
Okay, everybody, follow Erik De Leon on Instagram. Erik, tell everybody to follow you. When's your next fight? All the good stuff?
I'll be back sometime in March. You can follow me on Instagram at TeamDeLeon1. Twitter at GoldenDeLeon313.
All right, there you have it. A big night tonight for Detroit. Congratulations, Tony Harrison.
That's right. Congrats, my boy.
There you have it. Erik De Leon. Stay tuned for EsNews.com and Elie Seckbach reporting.